Hi, this is Tom Metzger, your host for Race and Reason again, that longest running show of its type on cable access TV. Seen around the country on many, many, many local cable access systems, and those cable access systems serve many times three, four, sometimes five towns and cities. And we're dedicated, of course, to freedom of speech, true freedom of speech, which upsets some of our opposition. We feel we're at island of free speech in a sea of controlled and managed news, and if you don't think news and so forth is controlled, only 26 corporations control all the media in the United States. So today we have a very interesting guest who has been on the show before. His name is Nicholas Schreck, and he has a musical group and organization called Radio Werewolf that he terms a musical terrorist organization, and he's also a revisionist writer who has written a book called The Study of Charles Manson. Nice to have you here.
Always a pleasure, Nicholas. To be here, Tom. How are you?
What's been happening to Nicholas Schreck since the last time we met?
Well, we're entering phase two of Radio Werewolf's operation for world dominion, and what we're waging is a cultural war right now on every front, in music, in literature, utilizing the media against itself. What we're trying to do is bring back a resurgence of the Western European tradition that has been all but lost in the world. And we're using music because that's the instrument that young people respond to right now. We're doing propaganda directly to awaken the wolf in man, because the wolf is a symbol of Western European power and fury, and that's why we use the werewolf imagery.
Now, you have used what you had termed neo-Gothic music in the past.
Well, Gothic, of course, is a Germanic tribe, and there's a spirit to the Western people that is unique in the world, and it is a Gothic spirit, and I think that's the purest form of Western culture, and I think we keep that flame alive in Radio Werewolf.
I understand you're talking about the evolution of this, that your music is getting more into the political...
Well, I wouldn't say political, because no. We transcend politics. Politics is merely the puppet show of human beings, and we transcend that, but we are interested in the control of human beings for our own purposes.
You have a symbol on your left arm here. Could you sort of scoot over? What is this?
This is the 13th rune in the ancient runic alphabet of the Norse people, and it represents Yggdrasil, the tree of life. And this is the meeting point between life and death.
Is that the tree that Odin was supposed to have been crucified on?
Exactly, and it's the tree that symbolically supports the universe. And the wolf's angle symbol we use as the symbol for the Abraxas Foundation, which is sort of a Thule society for the 90s. In the words of my collaborator Boyd Rice, it's a fascist occult think tank. And what we're doing is coming up with new strategies and techniques to bring this cultural renaissance into the future, into the 90s.
I notice you have a wolf's ring on your finger there.
Well, as I've explained, the wolf has always been a particularly Western European image, and the wolf represents the beast in man. That's what we seek to unleash in humanity, because it's been repressed and tamed by Judeo-Christian values, and that above all is what we seek to eradicate. The wolf should be unleashed. We can hearken back to Norse mythology, where Fenris, the ancient wolf god, was unleashed upon the world, and the Gotterdammerung occurred, the Ragnarok, the end of the world. And symbolically, that is what we are undergoing right now in history, an end of the old order, an end of the old world, and the beginning of a new order.
The end of the economic determinist idea and moving towards race and culture?
Of every idea, of every traditional idea of the past. In my opinion, we're living in a dead world. All the traditions of the past are decadent, dead, corrupt, and anyone who continues to cling to them are like maggots clinging to a corpse.
So the music today, you would see it as...
Music of today is absolute swill. It's designed to keep young people passive, restrained, and it's designed to tame them and keep them into sort of domestic sheep I would separate young people today into two breeds. There's predators, which are the wolves, and there are the sheep, and that's most of them. And we appeal to an elite. We are, frankly, an elitist organization. We seek a few excellent people. We don't want a lot of dross. We don't want a lot of mediocre followers. What we want are people who are capable of action.
Do you see do you see some elements of what you're talking about in other music that's...
I think the skinhead movement is a very positive step away from the decadence of the rock and drug culture that has dominated the youth so much. But as Adolf Hitler said, we seek to bring about a youth that has closed its heart to pity. All of the humanist values that Judeo-Christianity has encouraged, we want to wipe them out. It's led to democracy, social humanism, the idea of equality. All of this filth has to be wiped out if the human race is going to continue to take the next step in evolution.
What do you believe that would be like in, if you were in control as far as your attitudes towards your own people?
Well, we are in control because basically we are not a political organization. We are an occult organization. We're working behind the scenes to manipulate the way that people think. The war that we are waging is a guerrilla war on the human mind. And we use musical frequencies, the dominant frequency, which I've referred to before, and symbolism and imagery to awaken dormant aspects of the human mind.
Isn't it difficult to get club dates and things like that, obviously, once...
Well, we no longer are working in the context of that whole sphere of activities. We are moving into a much more elitist direction. We're only seeking individuals who are competent and who are willing to take action. There's a lot of people who will be an audience or a spectator, but we want people who will act.
And so the Abraxas Foundation has been for some time?
The Abraxas Foundation is an organization that Boyd Rice and myself founded, and it's dedicated to bringing about the values which we consider true and determined by the natural order. And in our opinion, humanity has moved away from nature, and race mixing, genetic suicide, the destruction of the gene pool, all of that is completely inimical to the natural order. We need to return to order.
Is this, could this parallel somewhat Nietzscheism and Nietzsche?
Well, Nietzsche was certainly a forerunner of our thinking because basically we're concerned with evolution, maintaining the very best of humanity and destroying weakness, destroying everything that Judeo-Christianity has succored and kept alive. We have no concern for the homeless, particularly. We don't have any concern in helping people. We're not seeking to convert people. As far as I'm concerned, in 1988, this is the cutting point. Either you are with us now, or you never will be with us.
What do you think about writers like, say, Oswald Spengler, writing in Decline of the West, the cycles of civilization?
I very much believe we are now in a cycle of order. The 60s, 20 years ago, represented a cycle of decay. And since my message is directly intended for young people, I would say it's about time that young people move away from the corrupt values of the 60s, the drug culture, race mixing, equality. The whole chaos of that period is ending, and we're going to see a new social movement in the 90s that will make Nazism and fascism look like kindergarten.